So in this video I want to talk about Reaktor. There are some flaws or some things you need to know when you start using Reaktor. At first when you open it, which doesn't take as long as on my other machine here since I haven't installed that much, or maybe on an M1 it works faster, I don't know. You get this option, you can say you don't want to see it, and that means you can choose between play, which means working with blocks, between play, which means working with ensembles and instruments, or patch, working with racks. I'm choosing play now, and I'm getting offered an ensemble. If I would choose new rack, I would get a rack here, and now the question is, what is it what you can see in your library? This is dependent on what you install in native access. For example, if you go to blocks primes and then under racks, and then you can see, for example, soundscape racks, and choose one, you get a whole rack with lots of things going on, and you can turn this off, and you can also choose, if you want, to save the rack as an ensemble. So if you do that, you still have the rack here, but you can load an ensemble. The ensemble is the highest level in the hierarchy of Reaktor, which is sometimes irritating because an instrument is on a lower level than an ensemble. So one ensemble can consist out of many instruments, and an instrument in Reaktor can also mean being a mixer or an effect. And then also things have changed between Reaktor 5 and 6, so lots of instruments from Reaktor 5 cannot be seen directly in Reaktor 6. I show you what I mean. I go down to my Reaktor factory library, and in there, for example, there are samplers, and if I choose, for example, memory drum, this is a very simple drum machine. This very simple drum machine can be played from my keyboard, and it also uses samples. You can use samples and you can see them here. With a right click you can remove them, but you see more information if you turn on the edit mode. The edit mode is only available if you have the full version of Reaktor. The edit mode means you can also see if those samples are embedded within the ensemble. That means you will never have a dialogue that says we are missing samples. And this is important, and it can also allow you to replace samples. And you can also save so-called sample maps, including audio data, which used to be very versatile. You could also import them into Kontakt. I haven't been able to do that with newer Kontakt versions, only with elder ones. And within this edit mode, you can also modify the ensemble. And now we can see the relation between ensembles, instruments, and blocks. Because if I enter memory drum here, I see the ensemble memory drum connected with the outputs. These are audio connections. And memory drum is capable of sending audio out to different outs. But in Logic, I have to open Reaktor in a multi-output mode, which I haven't done here. So out 3 to 6 are grayed out. But I can now, since I opened the edit mode, access a different tab in here, which is called Library, which is not there if I don't hit Edit. And there within Library, I see all these things that a musician or beginner may not understand. What's the difference between core, primary, and blocks? Well, now if I enter primary, I see parts that I can insert. For example, studio effects. I can also now right click and see the contents here and add them from here, for example, a flanger. So if I want to insert the flanger, I just have to remove the cable here. Trying to drag a new cable from the output will do the job. And then connect my memory drum to the flanger, and the flanger goes to this output. It's as simple as that, which would mean now, sorry, if I play drums with my keyboard, they are now affected by the flanger. So the flanger has an ending called .ism, which means instrument, while .ens is ensemble. And if you enter the blocks folder in here, you see all the nice blocks you can use while patching. And if you look at them closer, you see they are also .ism. They are this kind of instrument. So this is what Reaktor considers an instrument, which is, for the beginning, sometimes not so, sometimes confusing. So, for example, I could also patch the audio from my memory drum into a Monarch filter. And from the Monarch filter into the flanger. It's coming now only on one side, but you can hear it that it's working. And if you want to use the old Reaktor tools from Reaktor 5, you can access them more easily by using favorites. So if you want to access the instruments, you can access them here by going to a Reaktor 5 folder library, and in there is instruments. And if you enter this, there's a little bit more in here. For example, under effects, you find a lot more. The Flat Blaster is an interesting multiband compressor, or the Space Master is an interesting reverb. So you can all insert them, they are all ISMs. But they are not so easy to see or to access. But you could go and say, this is instruments, please add this to my favorites. Which would mean now I can see them here under favorites. I've done it twice, so I'm gonna delete one. So this is how you can modify and work with Reaktor ensembles and instruments and blocks. What you also gotta know is that this kind of modified ensemble cannot be saved by your DAW. It uses too much memory. This is shown by the red sign in here. They will be lost, these changes, closing the session. So you gotta save the new ensemble. And if you do this, the whole ensemble with all this stuff is saved. And you gotta make a difference between ensemble savings or saving a preset. If you wanna save a preset, the preset is only referring to an ensemble. And if you have an ensemble, you have always embedded presets, which are now here presets from the Space Master. And now within the edit mode, you can also see what is it here? What is it that you're seeing? This is the Space Master, but if I hit the ensemble memory drum as selected, then I see the presets of memory drum. All these parts in my ensemble can have different kind of snapshots. Obviously, you have presets for the reverb, you have presets for the flanger, but you can say memory drum is the master to rule them all, which means if I save a snapshot for memory drum ensemble, the other snapshots will be recalled. Nevertheless, I'm still able to add snapshots to the other parts, to the other instruments. But there's a difference between embedded presets, which used to be called snapshots, and user presets, which used to be normal external presets. But they are listed in here now, which makes it more convenient to work. But embedded ones are saved within the ensemble, which is sometimes a bit annoying, because if you change one ensemble and have nice presets in there and want to save it with your project, you might not want to use and change that ensemble with another project. So that might lead to some incompatibilities. So external presets or new presets that you do are meant to be saved outside the ensemble in order to work with only one ensemble that can be accessed by all the presets that you use in different projects. But in the edit mode, under properties, you can also manage which is the master of all those snapshots.